as a result of this, which is kind of a freak occurrence.
Yes, I wrote to the landfill, I said, you know, I haven't received any documentation to any of that.
Okay.
That was yesterday.
Should be good to go.
Was that a meeting?
No, it was like a board of 15.
Yeah, what did you get? I don't know, you didn't have any money. We didn't get a package.
But then you fired back.
Right, but I'm like, they sent me all yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah, accepted by you.
So where in Hawaii?
All over.
All over?
South and.
Yeah.
First.
Okay.
Staying, I've got some time here. Hawaii, and then I'm filling up with.
Ooh.
Navy.
Okay.
One of the northern islands for a week.
Here. Okay. So, oh, thank you, Renee, I like your data. Now, you've been,
We're saying, well, then we're, Hawaii.
11.5 inches.
11.5 inches, oh, yeah, that's a slab or?
As big as one I ever bought.
Really?
It's my kid, my kid. My boy, really caught some really nice bluegills. No. Fourth. Yeah, Karen, there's a bluegill that I caught on somebody.
On our lake.
Right.
That's nice.
Yeah. That was the biggest bluegill.
But he was going on, like.
Oh, and Don, yes.
Oh, you let him go out there, Dakota?
Adora.
Say, are we getting 10:30 started? People tend to come in.
Right, this is a little bit.
Cool, sure.
Go for it. Okay, we're gonna reopen the meeting of the Human Resources and Labor Negotiations Committee. We already did roll call, I do not see any, none committee board members present. Public comment.
I have a comment.
Please.
Two, actually.
Okay.
So I'm assuming, just assuming, correct me if I'm wrong, on the agenda, it talks about discussing review and making a decision on the COVID bonuses for the employees for Dodge County. Now, I'm assuming, because I've been at other HR meetings, that you're considering taking that from the ARPA funds. I know you can't answer a question, it's just a comment. I have done some further research on some of the guidelines that have now become firm rules. And according to a lot of the documents that I'm seeing, that is not allowed. And so my question would be, or my comment would be, if Dodge County is sued for misuse of ARPA funds, that's really not good. Also, your committee is expected to make decisions on agenda items when there is no packet. I just looked it up, so how are we supposed to review, consider, and make decisions based on no paperwork whatsoever? That's my comment.
Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else? Hearing none, okay. I need approval of the open session and closed session minutes of the regular meeting on October 5th, the open and closed session minutes of the special meeting on October 7th.
So.
Any corrections? Hearing none, a public question, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
consider employee COVID premium bonuses.
Okay, at the last meeting, we handed out a draft, I don't want to say proposal, but a draft outline of what a COVID bonus could potentially look like as it was directed or as it was drafted after the Columbia County's COVID bonus. And based on the discussion related to that, the committee wasn't in favor of kind of a multi-year structure as Columbia County. So what we did is put together, we just lobbed off the last 2 years, so 2021 and 2022. So 2021 would be everybody except Clearview, because as you know, Clearview's are under the CARES Act funding. And so eligibility would be, the amount would be 200 per month. So this, nothing's changed, 200 per month for anybody with an FTE of 0.5 to 1, and $100 per month for an FTE of 0.49 and below. This would be effective for the months of July 1 through November 30th, 2021. And the payment date would be January 7th. And then 2022, again, no change from the previous meeting. $100 per month for FTE of 0.5 to 1. $50 per month for an FTE of 0.49 and below. Starting January 1 through December 31, and they're paid on the first payroll following each quarter.
Some of the discussion last time was because we met before the finance committee had looked at it. Mm-hmm. So how did that turn out?
I was not there.
This proposal was not discussed at the last finance committee meeting. The finance committee is scheduled to meet again on November 1st.
Okay, yeah.
From a timing perspective, what we had talked about previously was based on discussions at the various committees would be to forward this to the county board in December, for that meeting is the 19th. So it's not imperative that a decision be made today, but it's to review the scope. And then also, the finance committee would be twice before then, because they're scheduled to meet November 1st, and they'll most likely meet sometime in early December. So there's time to further refine or do some additional research of this committee or the finance committee wants to do additional research. There's time to do that.
I think a lot of the discussion was, well, let's see what the finance committee said. If we're still waiting for that, I don't know.
Well, we can make a recommendation to the finance committee. So then that's good.
That's all we're looking for.
I guess my other question, did we cost this out?
The numbers keep changing, and we kind of need a decision to make before we can cost it out, because we're hearing what if this, what if that. I'm not trying to pass the buck, but we got two committees saying, let's wait for the other committee to do something.
I understand that also. I guess my question is, I guess we can just multiply this out. But I mean, saying with this proposal that we had suggested, I mean, if we didn't vote on it, but we kind of made a consensus. What would the one that's sort of before us, it would be nice to have a general idea of where that's going to be. I understand, and there was a comment regarding the ARPA fund, but I read through it and it seems that it's a covered benefit from what I read. Unless something's changed dramatically, do you know anything on that, Sarah?
I don't
guidelines have not been finalized. So it's still classified as interim final. But then the Treasury has released the document that even if their final rule, I should bring in the actual verbiage, but basically if their final guidelines differ from the interim, as long as you follow the interim guidelines, there's no repayment that would be required. And that's for all counties across the country, so that's what they issue.
Plus you've got the additional that lost revenue has very few restrictions on what we can use it for versus if it's under the related to the CARES Act. So if the board decides to go forward with this, whether you want to, you can call it lost revenue under the lost revenue clause, and there should not be any problem with it.
Yeah, no, I mean, I was listening to that meeting where the counsel for the WCA basically said if you follow the interim guidelines that the Fed set, that you're covered even if the final guidelines are different.
And that was just a recent statement by the Treasury, and the Treasury still hasn't provided a definitive timeline for releasing the final rules. That's still, at some point there will be some final rules, but at this point we don't know when that will be. And neither does Treasury. They haven't put in a timeline on that. And back to Dave's point, it's a valid point that if there's a recommendation comes out of this committee, then there's something solid to base the calculation off of, which would assist. Even then, we'd have numbers to present to finance at their next meeting, what the estimated expense would be.
So,
but if we have some agreement, you know, whatever the committee decides or recommends, then that's what would be used based on calculation.
So a real rough estimate based on employee counts as of 9/29, not including the Clearview CARES funding, the estimate would be 1.5, and that would be for 2021 and 2022 based on the discussion. Excuse me, the discussion at the last committee.
And that's the total cumulative 21 and
Yeah,
you know, I remember that, you know, David talking about the what if scenarios, and I know that we a couple of them have come up last month or last meeting, and I don't recall exactly what all the what ifs were and do they get covered or not covered, so I don't remember them offhand. Some of those what ifs were. I know you brought up a few, Richie. I did write them down, unfortunately. Does anybody remember what they were?
I don't feel so bad.
No.
Saying they have to be employed, they can't be rehired,
yeah.
And employed on this date. That's why they're saying. Active, receiving pay.
Current employee, or active employee, or whatever.
Yeah.
I know that was talked about.
Elected. He said all employees.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
Dan brings up a very good point, because before going to finance, that criteria needs to be established as well.
And that was some of the holdback last time, that we'd have to give them more.
Does anybody have, nobody's got it written down though?
But there was the initial criteria that was proposed.
The initial criteria was, and there was no, according to our discussion, you're more focused on the fact that it was a 4-year commitment. we pared it down to just this year and next year. So the criteria did not change. So it's eligibility, full and part-time employees must be employed the full month for each month in order to qualify for the bonus, and be an active employee receiving pay on January 7th, 2022. That's the payday.
That was one of my things that painted out 4 years. I said, how do you know what's going on in 23 and 24?
So as the conditions of what Sarah just read, I can support that, that they're active employees at the end. And that
every month.
And that they work during those periods of months that we had stated, I think it was sort of July. Start or something like that?
Yeah.
July 1st, November.
Yeah, 5 months, which would be a total of $1,000 for a employee of a 0.5 up to 0.1, or I'm sorry, 1.0, which coincides with the Clearview bonus of $1,000 for 2021.
So if those are the conditions, I guess you can not hold it up, but I mean, I think that's the condition that it would have to be about. But other than that, not coming out of any other brainstorms anybody has on what ifs.
Yeah.
I think that then I could see us recommending that with those conditions.
And those dates, those timelines.
Yeah. Unless you come up with something, Richie, but. I remember you talking, but it was that 4 years.
Yeah, that was the 4 years that I was so opposed to.
Yeah.
And we pared it down to 2 years, so I'm comfortable with it right now.
So, any other discussion? So, is it the committee's recommendation to recommend this to the finance committee as it's proposed?
Just for consensus?
Are you looking for just 2021 or is this the corporate 2022?
For the this is 21-22.
Okay. I think we need to clarify that.
Yeah, as proposed in the
okay. And you're set on the criteria then as outlined by Sarah? Because that should be part of it as well.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah.
What's in here?
Okay.
Consensus or a vote? Do you want consensus or a vote?
Vote.
Need a motion.
Make a motion to approve the criteria as leading for us in a draft.
For
21 and 22.
But should it be a not to split hairs, but should be a recommendation?
To go to finance.
Yeah. Yes.
Because the Human Resource Committee. Because it's the Finance Committee and County Board who has the approval. The other committees can recommend. We need to be clear on that, too.
You get that?
Yep.
Okay.
And that is actually in here, the conditions?
Eligibility is in there under each year. Each year there's the eligibility.
I'll second that it's a recommendation to the finance.
So the motion and the second discussion. I think that the question that we were talking about is if covered on the ARPA plan is actually quoted here, premium paid for essential workers. And it gives a paragraph as far as what that delineates. I think that will probably. Okay. Call the question. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All for the same sign.
Okay.
Okay. Discuss with you, consider CARES funding level, Clearview retention incentive.
All right. At the last meeting, this was approved, but with the caveat not to, or up to the $270,000 limit. And after reviewing the requirements under the rank, it's called regular wage under the FSLA, or weighted average overtime, we do need to include this incentive in the weighted average overtime calculation, and as a result that will probably increase the expected total amount beyond the $270,000. We just wanted to bring it back here because the motion was to approve it up to, but the fact that we do need to now include these incentives in the weighted average overtime for the date in which it's paid, we wanted to discuss it back here.
Is the CARES Act have enough money there that's not a problem if it went over the 270?
Well, there's, it was, we received well over $2 million, and I, if you, and I was just, you know, just for our comfort level, I would say it should not exceed $300,000. So,
and that shouldn't, well, I don't know, will that other projection, do you have any projections on what that would run then over and beyond the 270 that we were talking about?
He said
300. Said, I know you just said, oh, okay, not to exceed 300,000, right?
That's what it would cost, I think.
Yeah, our original calculation ran around 240, and when we brought it to the committee, we were thinking about overtime, but you know, as we talked to the labor attorney, they started running through FSLA and weighted average overtime, they added some money to that number, and that's what I'm just saying, for confidence sake, I would say 300,000
okay.
would be the limit, upper limit.
They're confident in it. There, yeah.
Any discussion on that?
That CARES Act funding has been rolled to the general, not the general fund, to your fund balance.
Correct.
Any excess?
Yes. Not the general fund.
No, their fund balance. Right. I said it wrong. Clearview's fund balance.
Okay. No questions. So basically, we're changing this from the 270 to 300.
Direction. and be able to communicate to employees what happens if you don't return the form, so.
I would think they would stay under the current plan.
I don't know that you can switch them without their consent.
I'm not thinking the other way. You take it automatically, or PTO, to give more incentive to respond to it.
The only thing it does, it makes it look like PTO is punitive.
Yeah.
And you don't want to make that concept, you know, it's like, if you don't do this, we're going to do this. It's not, I think, a good way to do it. I would hope that people would respond.
I would think we would, but just, you know, what, we don't want to be stuck with on the 19th, oh my gosh, you know, we've got, even if it's one person, what do we do with them?
I guess on the election form, are you giving them a yes or no, or?
Yeah, depending on how election form is.
It is going to state, I want to transfer to PTO, or I want to stay with sick vacation.
So you're giving them a choice.
Well, you got both options.
And if they don't reason, if they don't, yeah.
And if they don't, we don't have any default.
That's why we're asking, that's what we're looking for.
What's the default then be?
Switch them over.
No, I see that, but it makes PTO look punitive.
I don't know why it's punitive either way then.
But if they're currently.
You could put on that election form and state that if you don't return this form.
It'll be like a new employee.
Yep. I personally, I'm not there on that, but that's.
I mean, you can say it, but I don't think you can do it.
I mean, we don't give them choices to the new employees hired. They'll be automatically in it. So if somebody doesn't want to make out a form request, that, and the both options are there, so we're not saying if you don't, you know, but we could say you'd be treated like the incoming employees, you'll automatically be switched.
That should be on the form.
Yeah, it's got to be on the form for the.
Suppose you put it on their form and their form, because they don't have much of a job.
I'm with you if they don't, you can't switch them.
Okay.
They're not a new employee. They are in the system.
But if they don't make an option, somebody will.
That's just. I certainly hope they'll be few and far between.
Like I said, we will do everything we can to track everybody down, but like I said, we didn't want to be in the 11th hour and be standing there going, now what?
I believe that it should be on the form that if you don't respond, that they'll be treated as a new employee and a lot of ads will be put on to you.
Okay, you want to make that move?
All we'd have to do is say, everybody is switching to PPO unless you declare that you want to stay under the old plan. That's what we're doing in the future. Except new regular employees are getting a choice. But again, it doesn't sound like I got the majority of that thought.
I mean, there's a consensus thing. We're not making a decision. Doesn't say make a decision. So consensus. I mean, I can see the advantage in both ways. It's just I just don't want to make it punitive.
Like I said, it's on the form and they're aware of that. It's not turning in that form. So be it. But I mean, just to say that if they didn't turn in the form, you're going to put them on PTO without telling them the consequences. No, I can't get there.
Well, yeah, I agree, yeah. Unless you sign that you want to stay current,
right.
You're switched.
That's my thought.
Are we have a consensus?
Okay, thank you.
You're going to have three options there, right?
No. We'll draft the form for us tonight.
Well, one, that they go to PTO, two, they don't go to PTO or stay at a they don't answer, well, that's not out.
No.
If they don't answer, respond, they will automatically.
You just want the note on there.
Yes.
Yes, we will get it. Yeah.
Is that right? Okay.
Okay, review, discuss, consider personnel requisitions.
Economic support specialist, Heather Hull has resigned her position with the county.
There's only one.
Motion to accept it, second.
Second.
Richie, second. Discussion. Hearing none, I'll call the question. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion passes. Leave of absence request.
We have two. What is your pleasure? Do you want them together again?
Sure.
Wonderful. The first employee is from the sheriff's office. This is for a continuous leave for the employee. We have supporting medical documentation. It just did not meet the level of the criteria as a serious health condition under FMLA. So that's why it's being brought to you, because it's a paid medical leave. The other one is for an employee at Human Services and Health. We do have supporting medical documentation. This is for an employee who has been employed for less than 12 months and therefore not eligible for FMLA.
And you got paid there, right?
It actually is paid, yes. They have enough paid time to cover it.
Get motion approved.
Second. Motion, second. Discussion. Hearing none, call the question. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. That motion passes. Review of salary, wage, and status changes.
Great. We have a new hire in the union, Jonathan Weaver, deputy sheriff, will be starting with us on 10/22. We have a new hire, full-time Kinsey Dettert, physical assistant in human services, starting with us on 10/25. We have a new hire part-time. This is an appointed official with the Veterans Service Commission, Michael Waynard, who did start on 1/19 of 2021. We've just notified of the fact that he was appointed back then. We have a transfer, Tracy Sofsted, senior social worker, transferring to CPS investigator intake on 10/7, and then Jade Van Buren, transferred into a behavioral health therapist in training on 10/7. And that is it.
I have a question on Jonathan Weaver.
Mm-hmm.
He's starting at top wage of sergeant.
He is at the shift differential. He comes from, I believe, Dane County. Many years of experience. So.
Okay, that's I was wondering if the 3102 was our starting wage. He's starting at the top, so that's nice.
The okay. Shift differential.
Okay.
Any other questions? Okay, give me a brief report.
Employee resignations and retirements. Wendy is not able to be here today. We've got an RN on call who left employment. Her indication was too much with her other job. RM supervisor on call, same thing, too much with her other job. And then we have a payroll coordinator who is taking a position with the Houstonburg School District. And then as far as resignations, you'll have to help me out
yep.
because.
Communication officer is leaving, and then we have a deputy secretary that is going to be retiring in December.
The payroll coordinator that was Clearview?
Mm-hmm.
No, the new higher one. He was HR or something.
Yeah, okay. That's yeah.
And the RM was just a part-time?
Those were on calls.
I'm just on call part-time.
Yep.
What kind of recall line? You know what she was?
On call, so as
yes,
needed.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions on that? No? Okay. 12 and 13 are done. Future agenda items.
He's contract.
Yeah, that's no question. Anything else coming up? No, that's enough. Okay. Next meeting date. So we have the
special meeting on 10/29 at 9 o'clock a.m. for negotiations.
And our regular meeting.
We're calling that the special meeting November 2nd at 9 o'clock. That is to meet with the association.
Okay.
And then do we want to cancel our regular meeting, reschedule it? What's
still got everything else?
We didn't have too much else on the agenda other than, I mean, subsequent agenda items.
So our next regular meeting, then you're looking at like the 16th.
Mm-hmm.
16th.
Yeah.
Okay with that?